Hey, what's going on, guys? Parakeet Man here, and this is MTX Motocross on PlayStation 2. I was wanting to play PS2. I didn't think I had one here at my house, but I went diving into my brother's closet, who never actually played video games, so I don't know why it was up there. But anyways, it was up there, and I still have all the old PS2 games I used to play, and this was one of my favorites. Everyone talks about GTA and Metal Gear games and games like that, and of course those games were awesome, and I love them, and I played the hell out of them, but games like this, MTX, Motocross, and Dave Mira, I was really into like extreme sports, or action sports, whatever you want to call them, when I was younger, still am, but I don't pretend like I do them or anything, but I loved MTX Motocross. It's one of my all-time favorite games, I mean, to the point where I'm still playing it right now, and still having fun, and I thought I would kind of record some games. I thought maybe of doing a let's play through the career mode of it, at least the races and probably also the freestyle. I don't know about the compound stuff. After you get through Travis's compound, Travis Pastrana's, it gets kind of stupid and boring. I'll do it to get the tricks, but I don't know if I'll make a big deal out of it. But so I might not be talking over every single video, and if I do talk, it probably won't be throughout the entire video. I just want to say how much fun it is playing this game. If you guys have a PS2 around and you want to play a new game, this game's really underrated. Chances are you've never even heard of this game. But there's racing, obviously. It's all dirt bikes, so there's no ATVs. But there's racing, there's freestyle mode, and then there's free ride mode where they have just big areas that have jumps built into them, where you can go to Travis Pastrana's house, his compound. And it has all this tracks and jumps and stuff. And when you play career mode, you can go to freestyle and compete in freestyle events. You can go to compound and practice moves and learn new tricks. And at the same time, you can do little challenges and stuff. And then you can go to the racetrack. So there's actually a lot you can do. You can customize your rider, a little bit. Can't customize your bike, but you can get new bikes and you can get new sponsors. And I think I remember if you do a lot of tricks in the middle of races, your sponsors won't be happy, but the clothing company No Fear will love it, so they'll sponsor you because you do tricks in the middle of races. And so it's a really good game. It's really underrated, and the tricks aren't actually always that easily done. Flips and 360s are actually pretty difficult to do. I know a lot of people, when this game was popular among my friends, a lot of them couldn't do backflips. They just couldn't do it. You had to time it perfect, and you just had to be good. I remember there's another motocross game when this came out that was really good too, but to do a backflip, all you had to do was push right on the right analog stick, and you flipped, or you spun, or you front flipped, whatever it is. And this game has a few fantasy tricks, but for their time, they were fantasy tricks. Now they're not. There's a barrel roll, which I don't really think anyone's ever done a barrel roll. But it's possible, but they have like a, or a bike flip, but they have like body variables and stuff, and at the time when this game came out, that was all fantasy. And now it's, I actually saw someone do it yesterday, just casually do it, so there's not too much fantasy involved in this game, and it's just a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun to kind of, learn how, which jump you need to pre-spring on, and which jumps you can just fly over, and there's really nice rhythm sections when you really get into it, and you just let your speed carry you over jump after jump after jump. And some of the tracks have different ways you can go, that not like secret passages, but you can either go the left way or the right way, and depending on your style, it will pick the one that suits you. So it's a really good game. So if you guys are still playing PS2, I'm happy I found mine. There's all these games. I had my memory card, and I was looking at my memory card, and man, I remember the game Bully. I totally forgot about that game. That was on there. SSX on Tour was on there, and this game, and then the classics, they're Metal Gear 2, Metal Gear 3, and then GTA games and stuff like that. But if you guys have a PS2 laying around and you want to play fun game, I imagine you could find this easy on Amazon or on at GameStop. Just don't ask me to send you mine because this is one of my all-time favorite games. I might be overrating it, I don't know, but I love this game. It's one of the most fun I've had. So I'll do a little kind of a let's play career mode, and tell me what you guys think about the game, if you've ever played it and if you liked it, and I will talk to you guys later. Thanks.
This track has the